Hi everyone, good morning. Welcome to our channel V2V. And you can follow our channel in Telegram, Instagram, Facebook for more updates. So everyone, just copy the link and share to your friends. Just inform to your friends the live is started, guys. All the PDFs which are available in the Telegram, you just follow me in the Telegram. And first of all, please confirm, guys, is my audio and video both clear? Then we'll start our session. Everyone, just share our video link, guys. Okay, yes, question number one. So question number one related for simple interest, guys. And just read the question, understand the information, and find out whatever we required information. And first of all, I will give you some information related for simple interest. See how we are generally calculated simple interest. Simple interest is calculated based on principal, based on time period, based on rate of interest. So all these three parameters are most important to get the simple interest of given amount. That's why the formula of any simple interest is exactly equal to PTR by 100. So that is the basic formula. We already know that, guys. Now, just read the information. A sum of 1250 rupees. So there is a sum of 1250 rupees. And then partly, so there is a dividing. So one of the amount we are dividing, that is exactly equal to 13% per annum. And other amount they given in terms of 17% per annum. And the total interest earned for the entire transaction, for 125 rupees for 3 years. So 125 rupees for 3 years. Then find the ratio of sum lent at 13% to the sum lent at 17%. Now we already know that we are dividing the 1250 rupees into the two parts. So one at 13% per annum, other one is 17% per annum. Now, so there is a two dividing parts here. X plus Y can be considered as 1250. Now, X amount they given as 13%, Y amount they given as 17%. Now see, so X amount means X into 13% into time period 3 years divisible by 100 plus other amount converted into single parameter. So 1250 minus of X into, so the rate of interest exactly equal to 17% for 3 years divisible by 100. Why? Because we already know that simple interest is equal to PTR by 100. Now see, the total interest earned for those two transactions exactly equal to 425. So this is the equation base. See, first amount just assume as X and other amount is 1250. And we already know that simple interest formula PTR by 100. But this is one of the approach that is based on the concept of simple interest. But we'll go the other approach based on the concept of allegation mixes. Now that is easy when compared to these methods, guys. Then I will tell you the approach. See, first I clearly mentioned that, see, we have individual information. Rate of interest is 13%, 17%. The total interest earned by 3 years is 425. And we already know that rate of interest is always per year, guys, but they given us information for 3 years. First of all, see, 425 rupees you can get for 425 rupees you are getting for 3 years. 3 years interest is equal to 425. And we already know that, guys, every year the simple interest is constant. Every year the simple interest is constant. Per year amount exactly equal to 425 by 3 years. That is exactly for per year. And this is the amount, see, this is the amount we are getting for 1250. Why? Because the combination of X amount and Y amount is 1250. Now, out of 1250, they get 1 year interest exactly equal to 525 by 3. Now, we want rate of interest. Rate of interest means 525 by 3 and divisible by 1250. And we want in terms of percentage means that is multiple with a 100. Now, see, guys, so I will go with the 25 into 50. So this is in terms of 25 into 21. So 3 ones are 3, 3 sevens are. And 50 ones are 50, 50 twos are. So 7 twos are 14%. Now see, the mixed value exactly equal to equal to 14%. Now see, I took it as X amount. The rate of interest is exactly indicated as 13%. I took it as Y amount. It is exactly equal to 17%. The overall, if you go through the combined transaction, they can get 425 rupees for 3 years. The rate of interest exactly equal to 14%. This is the allegation mixes. Now see, if you want the value of X means subtracted 17 minus 14, the value become 3. If you want Y value means 14 minus 13, the value become 1. So the ratio become 3:1. So this is the method 2, guys. Now everyone is clear? So there is a concept of allegation mixes, guys. So either you can go through the concept of simple interest, direct formula, otherwise you can go with the allegation mixes. You need to understand these particular point. If you understand these particular point, then you can easily handle these type of questions, guys. Clear for allegation method? Let's move on to the next question. Next. So, ages, definitely you can expect the question, guys. So, middle value means the PMC, middle value means we already know that the overall interest for 13% is 17%. If you calculated combined interest, you can get 525. So, 525 you can get for 3 years. Per 1 year, 525 by 3. So, these interests we are getting based on the principal. We already know that combined principal is 1250. That's why 425 by 3 divisible by 1250 into 100. Then you can get the central value, central tendency means central value of overall transaction. Then you can go with the allegation mixes. Now see the information. So there is information related for present. See, what is the information present? See, so there is a discussion for two important parameters, mother and son. What is information? See, the present age of mother is 3 times the present age of son. Now you just assume the son age is X, then mother age is 3 times means the value becomes 3X. That is the first important parameter. 5 years hence, so they are discussing after 5 years. Now see, 5 years hence, 5 years, the age of mother is 3X plus 5. The age of son is X plus 5. Then there is a one important statement. 5 years hence, the mother age will be 5 by 2 times of age of his son. Now see, age of mother 3x plus 5 exactly equal to 5 by 2 times of son. Son age is x plus 5. Just cross multiply. Nana. See, 6x plus 10 exactly equal to 5x plus 25. Yeah. So this is the value. Now you can get x is equal to 15. Now x is equal to 15. Now you can get the present value. See, the present value exactly equal to 45. So 3 into 15. Then the son value become exactly equal to 15 years. So these are the present ages. Now what is your question? See, after 10 years. Now see, after 10 years, mother age is 55. After 10 years, son age is 25. Now here the question. After 10 years from now, the mother age will be how many times of age of his son? So mother age is how many times of son's age? Simply 55 by 25. Now see, 5 5s are 5 11. 11 by 5 value become 2.2 times. Yes. Then mother age will be 2.2 times of son's age after 10 years. Now you can choose your option 2.2 times. Next. So data interpretation question. See, what is the information they given for these data table? Study the table given the follow and answers. Just go through the answers based on the data interpretation. Now, table given below shows the total votes. There is a total votes polled in 6 villages. 6 villages are A, B, C, D, E, and F. And the percentage of invalid votes. So, these are the total number of votes in the box and the total number of villages and the percentage of invalid. We already know that 100% is exactly equal to total polled votes. 100%. Now, these 100% is a combination of valid plus invalid. For example, if A city is 11 1/9% is invalid, means remaining, if you want, 100% minus 11 1/9% is valid. So, So in that way, just converted valid and invalid. See, after subtracting invalid votes, so we left with the valid votes, and valid votes can be distributed. Valid votes can be distributed three parties. Those are X, Y, and Z. So that is the overall information. So based on that information, you need to calculate the given question, guys. Just go through the information. Just go through the information. Now see that. Total valid votes received by party Y in village D. Now the question related for village D. So just concentrated on village D. Now village D, the total number of votes are 3,200. So out of invalid votes are 30%. Now definitely the valid votes are 70%. We already know that percentage 00 cancel. The valid votes are 32 into 70. Now these votes we need to distribute 1-3-4 ratio, X party, Y party, Z ratio. See, the total votes is 8. For example, if the total votes is 8, then 1 vote is related to the X, 3 votes is related to Y, 4 votes is related to the Z. Now see, now we want Y party votes, guys. Y party votes means Y is 3 units out of 8. Now see, if you want Y votes only, 3 by 8 of given votes. Now you just calculated 8 1s are 8, 8 4s are 32, guys. Now here the value, see 4 3s are 12 into 70, guys. 7 2s are 14, 1 here, 7 1s are 7. So 840 votes getting by party Y in village D. Now see, this is the information is what percentage the total valid vote received by party X in village A. So village A, the total number of votes are 4,500, point number one. Now 11 1 by 9 percentage means the value become a fraction 1 by 9. See, 1 by 9 is invalid. See, it means out of 9, 1 vote is invalid. Now how many are valid, guys? See, in the village A, the total number of valid votes are 1 minus 1 by 9. 1 minus 1 by 9 means 8 by 9th of total polled votes. The total polled votes are 4,500. Now see. So 9 become 4,500 is equal to 500. Now see, here the value become exactly equal to 4,000. Now here the question, see. Now the total valid votes received by party Y in village D. So 840 is what percentage the total valid votes received by party X in village A. Party X, guys. Now see, here party X value become exactly equal to 3 by 8. Again, see, 3 by 8th of 4,000. See, we already know that this is the value become exactly equal to 500. So the value become 1500. See, this is the value of 1500 into 100. Now double zero cancel. Just calculated, Nana. See, 5s are 75, guys. 15 7s are 75. We left with the 90. And 15 6s are, guys. So the percentage value become exactly equal to 56%. So 56% is correct answer. No, Priyam, you can convert it into the fraction, Nana. That is better. 100% is minus 11, 1 by 9% means you left with the 8 by 9%, but it is difficult to you calculated the type of mixed fraction. That's why now if you good at a conversion, just go and watch my percentage basic video. In that video we already discuss how we are converting fraction to the percentage, percentage to the fraction. You need to recognize 11 1 by 9 percentage means if the fraction become a 9, definitely the fraction value become 1 by 9. If 1 by 9 means out of 9 votes 1 is invalid, now definitely remaining fraction is 8 by 9. So better to convert the percentage value into the fraction, then it is easy to calculate it whatever the question, guys. Conversions are most important. Go through the next one. Let's see the question number two. What is the ratio of total valid votes received by party X in village E? Now the information related for E, Nana. Out of 5,000, 16% are invalid. Definitely, the valid is exactly 84%. Now you cancel percentage 00. Now you left with the value of 50 into 84. And these votes, we can distribute it three parties, for example. So, add 2 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 4. Now, see, 2 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 4. Out of 4 votes, 2 votes are related to the X, 1 vote is related to the Y, and 1 vote is related to the Z. We want the party X. Party X, 2 votes out of 4. Now, see, this is the value, 2 by 4. Now, you can get the value of X party in village Z. Don't multiply, guys. Why? Because we want ratio, no? Next one. The total valid votes received by party Z in A, guys. Party Z in A. Now, see, the total number of votes are 4,500. Now, here the valid votes are 8 by 9. So, 8 by 9 means the value become 8 into 500. Now, we want the party Z. Party Z means, now again, distribution, see. Out of 8 votes, 3 votes are related to the party Z. Now, here the value become 3 by 8. Now, then it is better to get the calculation, guys. See, it is easy. Now, 8 cancel. Now, here 4, 21 times. Now, there is no problem here. 50 ones are 15, 15, 10 jar, guys. Now, see, 3 ones are 3, 3, 7 jar, guys. Now, again, here 2 ones are 2, 2, 5 jar, guys. Now, the ratio become 7 is to 5. So, that is the answer. The ratio become 7 is to 5, guys. Is the question, so that you can get the ratio is exactly 7 is to 5, guys. Next one. Let's focus on the calculation and everyone. Let's see the next one. See, the total votes polled from village D is 80% of the total register votes in the voting list. Now, see, now they are discussing for village D. Now, total polled votes are exactly equal to 83,200. Now, if you want voting list, see, we know that, see, we have 100 votes in a voting list. Out of 100, 80% only for polled one. So, definitely 20% votes are not in voting, not in voted. Now, see, we need to identify the voting list. Means, see, this is the value exactly equal to 80% value exactly equal to 3200. So, 80% is equal to 3200. Now, voting list. Voting list means definitely 100%. Nana, see, 80% become 3200. Each unit is 400 times. Nana, now, see, each unit is equal to 40 times. Now, 100% means the total number of votes. Voting list, polled in voting list is exactly equal to 4,000. So, voting list votes are 4,000. Now, the total votes polled from the village D in 80% of the total register votes in the voting list. So, voting list votes are 4,000. Then, find the winner party from village D received what percentage with respect to the register votes. Now, see, register votes are 4,000. Now, the total number of polled votes are 3,200. Out of 3,200, 30% votes are invalid. Now, valid votes are exactly equal to 70%, means 70 by 100 of 3,200. Now, the value becomes 70 into 32. Now, see here the information. Find the winner party. Who wins the party? Definitely, Z win the party, guys. Why? Because he got more number of votes. Now, see, here the ratio become exactly equal to total, we have 8 votes. Out of 8, 4 votes are related to the Z. Now, see, 8 ones are 8, 8 fours are 32. Now, the value becomes 16 into 70, guys. Now, what is the question? See, then find the winner party of D received what percentage with respect to that. Winner party, how much you got? So, 16 into 70 divisible by, now they compare with the registered vote. The total registered votes are exactly equal to 4,000. We want percentage means into 100, guys. Now see, we have a 00000 cancel, 4 4s are 16, so 7 4s are 28%. When compared to that, guys, see, when compared to the voting list, they got 28% of votes. The answer becomes 28%, guys. 28% is the correct answer. Next one. Next question. So you can see, the total valid votes received party X in village E and F together. Now see, here E. Here, the total number of valid votes are 84%. Now see, percentage 00 cancel. We left with a value 84 into 50. Now we want the village party X. So party X value become, out of 4 votes, they get a 2. So the value become 2 by 4. You can get E value. And we require F is also together, guys. We want FCT also together for XC. Out of 5,500, 20% is valid. You cancel these two numbers. You left with the 80%, guys. 80%. 80% value become 4 by 5. Or otherwise, you can go with 80 into 555. So, 80 into 55. Now, we want the X party. See, we total number of votes are 11. And out of 11, 6 votes are related to the X. So, 6 by 11. This is the fraction. Now, you just calculate it. Anna. So, this is exactly for 21 times. This is exactly for 5 times. Now, see. So, 52s are 100. So, the value becomes 2100. That is the calculation here. So, 6 5s are 30. 8 3s are 24. Means the value becomes 2400. If both are added together, the resultant become exactly equal to 4500. So, the party X get by E and F villages. Now, see, when compared to that, see, how much percentage more or less the total register votes of C? The total polled is 70% of the total register votes. See, C total number of votes are exactly equal to 3500. See, 3500 exactly equal to 70% of total register vote. If you want the total register vote, means 100% is equal to how much? You can cancel percentage cancel. So this is exactly value become 50. So 50 into 100, the value become 5000. What is your question? See, 4500 is how much more or less, not percentage, how much more or less? Definitely 500 votes are less when compared to the voting list in village C, guys. So how many less here? 500 votes are less. So go to the next one. Data interpretation needed a calculations, guys. The next question. What is the average? We already know that. See, average can be calculated sum divisible by number. Then what is the average of total valid votes? Valid votes received by party X in village B. So village B, 4,400, 25% is invalid, 75% is valid. 75% means 3 by 4th of 4,400. So that is the value. Now, so you just cancel here. This is exactly equal to level 100. So the value become 3300. Now party x distribution. See, guys, party x distribution means we have 11 units, 11 votes. If you have 11 votes, 5 units getting by x, 3 votes getting by y, 3 votes getting by z. Now see, the value become exactly equal to 5 by 11. 5 by 11 means this is absolutely for 300 times, and the value become exactly equal to 15. You can get one of the variable, the value become 1500. You already calculated party X in village B and valid votes received by Z in village D. Now you concentrated on village D. So out of 3200, 70% is exactly equal to valid number. Now percentage 00 cancel. You left with the value of 70 into 32. Again, we want party Z. Party Z means total number of votes are 8. 4 votes are related to the party Z. So, 4 by 8 means the value become 1 by 2. So just cancel 2 1s are 2. 2 16s are 2 16s are means. See, 7 6 are 42, 4 here, 7 1s are 7, 7 plus 4, 11. So you can get 1120. Now we want average. Average means sum divisible by number, guys. Sum divisible by number means 2620 divisible by 2. So the value become 1310. The value become 1310. So that is the ratio base. Next, one more question. See, diamond work. See, if you solve any diamond work question, we require two important information. One, efficiency. Efficiency is inversely proportional to the time, and just concentrated on the total work. Why? Because these are the two important parameters, guys. So, if you go with a multiple comparison, if you want the total work, so the total work is completely depends on the LCM of given parameter. So remember those two points, then you can easily solve whatever the question is related for time and work. Now, see, there is a person. Abhi takes 40% is more time. They are concentrated on the time, guys. See? So, time. And there is a comparison between two persons, Abhi and Ashu. Now, Abhi took 40% is more time when compared to the Ashu. See, for example, if they completed in 100 units of time, then Abhi took 440 units of time. So, if you're comparing in terms, who are completed the work in less number of days, he is the most efficient person. See, definitely, Ashu is most efficient person when compared to the B. Remember the point. Now, see, here the ratio become exactly equal to 7 is to 5. This is the time, but we need an efficiency. And I already clearly mentioned that, see, in efficiency is always inversely proportional to the time. Efficiency is inversely proportional to the time. Now, see. See, inversely proportional to the time means the ratio of efficiency always be the 5 is to 7. So, 5 is to 7. Now, see here. So, efficiency can calculated always be the Faraday. So, Faraday efficiency means they're performing. So, performing Abhi 5 units in a day, Ashu is 7 units a day. So, Faraday who are performing more number of units, of course, he is the most efficient person. If it is a more efficient person, definitely he can completed the work in less number of days when compared to the other person. So that is the two important parameters. Now see, we just know that. So we just know the information. What is information? We already know that. See, Abhi performing 5 units per day. Ashu performing 7 units per day. Now see, if Ashu works for X day, see, we already know that Ashu can do 7 units per day and they're working for X days. So they are completed 5X number of units. 5X number of units. That is the first information. After that, remaining work. So, remaining work means Ashu may be left the work and remaining whatever the remaining work, he can complete it in X plus 4 days. And we already know that. See, per day, Abhi can done 5 units. So, he completed the remaining work in X plus 4 units means the total number of units done by Abhi exactly equal to 5X plus 20. So, these are the number of units performing by Abhi and Ashu. Now, the ratio of work done. So, the ratio of work done by Ashu. So, how much work done by Ashu? 5x units divisible by Abhi. 5x plus 20. Then, ratio exactly equal to 7 by 9 cross multiply. 45x exactly equal to 7 5s are 35. Sorry. 9 5s are 45. 7 5s are 35. So, 35x plus 149. This is the information. Sorry. 7, this is 7x, nano. This is 7x. 7, 9 is 63. 63x. Now see, 63 and 23, the difference exactly equal to 28x. So, 28x is equal to 150, then x value become exactly equal to 5 units. Now, we want a total work. See, first you need to calculate the total work. Total work means, see, Abhi done 7 units per day. They're working for, see, they're working for X days. So, X days means here 5 days. 7 5s are 35 units, guys. Now, he was doing X plus 4 days. X value, we already know that 5. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. 9 5s are 45 units. Now, the total number of units here exactly equal to 80. What is the total work? So, the total work is exactly equal to 80 units. Now, the question. Find in how many days Abhi will complete the work alone. See, Abhi, we already know that Abhi efficiency, they're performing 5 units per day. If the total work assigned by Abhi, he can complete it in how many days? Number of days. So, that is exactly equal to 16. Why? Because 80 units and they're performing 1 day unit is equal to 5 units. So, if you want completed 80 units, it took only for 16 days. Answer 16 days is the correct answer. One more question. One day work, see, remember, one day work means they are discussing for efficiency, guys. One day work is always deals with the efficiency. Now, see, there is a man, woman, child. So, one day work means definitely efficiency. Based on the efficiency only, we can distribute it amount, guys. See, the ratio of efficiency exactly equal to 5 is to 3 is to 2. And if there are 8 men, if there are 8 men, 12 women, 16 children. So, the number of people. So, number of people. See, 8 men, 12 women, 16 children. Now, see. To complete the work. See, if they complete the work, they can get an amount of 5,400. Now, see, guys. Now, number of people 8, their efficiency 5, they're performing 40 units. If number of people are 12, the efficiency of each woman is 3, they're performing 36 units. If number of people, 16 children, they're performing 2 units, the value becomes 32. Just cancel number. Say 4 tens are, 4 nines are, 4 eights are. It means, see, if they're performing 27 units, if they're performing 27 units, 10 units done by man, 9 units done by woman, and 8 units done by children. What is your observation? Based on the performance only, the amount we are dividing. Now, see, if they're performing 10 units means out of total amount, they can took 10 units of amount. They took 9 units of amount. They took 8 units of amount. Now see, the total amount exactly equal to 5,400. Now see, 27 become 5,400. Then each unit is equal to 200, guys. Each unit is equal to 200. Now see, the man get exactly equal to 2,000 rupees. So, women get 9 twos are 1,800 rupees. And 8 twos are 1600 rupees. Now see the entire work of 5400. If you go through that 8 men, 12 women, 16 children. Now they get 2000 rupees, 1800 rupees and 1600 rupees. That is the information here. Now what is the question? Now dividing in the ratio of man, woman and child. Now if the total waste, find the total waste if 10 men, 12 women in a 1 month. So what is the total is if they are working for 10 men and 12 women, guys. Now, see guys, we already know that this is the 2000 rupees, they can get the number of people, sir, 8 guys. The total number of 8 people, they can get 2000 rupees. If each man get 2000 by 8, each man get 2000 by 8. Now, how many men are there? 10 men are there. Now, you can get the value, see. 4 2s are, 4 5s are. 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are. Now, see, 5 5s are value means 2500 guys. So, that is the man amount. Again, concentrated on men. See, 1800 amount, they can get in for 12 men. Say, 1800 rupees, they are getting for 12 men. And women. So, each woman amount exactly equal to 1800 by 12. Here, assigning by total number of women, sir, 12 men. Now, you can cancel. This is the amount, see, 1800. Now, the total amount getting by the two persons exactly equal to 4,300. So, the value becomes 4,300 is the correct answer. There is a question related for probability. Now see, a bag containing 6 white balls and 4 black balls. So in a bag, there are 6 white balls and 4 black balls. Out of these ones, see, if two balls are drawn at a random and find the probability they are in the same color. See, they mentioned that same color means they are not mentioned whether the two balls are white or black. We don't know it. So there is a chances. Either we can get either 2R white or 2R black. But 1 white is 1 black is not a possibility, guys. Why? Because they clearly mentioned that we want 2 balls. Those 2 balls are same color. Now see, the total how many balls are there? So 10 balls are there. See, out of 10, we require 2. That is the total probability. So out of total possibilities, we require 2 balls. We require 2 balls, whether that is white or black. White or black. See, getting white case is 6C2. Getting black case is 4C2. Why? Because that is either or. Either or means we can't show with a single operation. Now, what is the final value? See, 6C2 means 6 into 5 by 2 into 1 plus 4 into 3 by 2 into 1. Again, 10 into 9 by 2 into 1. If you are good at a calculation, no need to take any denominators. Now, see, 6 5 is 30 and 4 3 is 12. The value become 42. Again, 10 9 is 90. You know, we just calculated in 3 table. See, 3 1s are 3. So 3 1s are 3. 3 14s are 3 13s are 2 7s are 2 15s are. So the fraction becomes 7 by 15. So 7 by 15 is the perfect answer. Yes, we have a number to this question. So what are the numbers here? 19. 26, 52, 115, 239 dash. Now, if you go through that, if you think it is a multiplication, for example, 19 ones are 19 plus 7 is equal to 26. But if you go through the 26 twos are, that is 52, guys. So it is difficult to get in the multiplication. If you are not getting in the multiplication, then find the difference, guys. In that way, you just observe the entire numbers. Now, here the numbers between both the are 7, the difference. Here the value become 26 is the difference. Here 52 means we have a 48 extra and 15 extra. The value become exactly equal to 63. Now we added 63 variables. Again 115 become 115 extra, 230. Again you need to add 9. The value become 124. Now if you recognize the number, see, 7, 26, 63, 124, all the numbers are nearer to the perfect cube. Nearer to the perfect cube means, see, 2 cube minus 1 number. This is 3 cube minus 1. And this is for 4 cube minus 1. And this is for 5 cube minus 1. So definitely, see, 2, 3, 4, 5, definitely the next value becomes 6 cube minus 1. And 6 cube is 216. Again, minus 1. We need to add 215 variables to the 239. You see? 9 plus 5 is equal to 14, 1 carry forward. We required 4 as the units plus we have a only one chance the answer become 454. 454 is the perfect result. Next one. 28, 98, 157, 205. 242. Again, all the numbers are nearer. If all the numbers are nearer, just find the differences. 28 become a 98, definitely we are adding 70 variables. Now see, here we just add, see, here 57 plus 2. So we are adding 59 variables. Again, see, 157 become a 205. Here we have a 43 plus 5. We are adding only 48 variables. 48 variables. Again, see, 205 become a 42. 205 become a 42. Again, we just add 37 variables. We are adding 37 variables. If you see the number 70, 59, 48, 37, again, every time they are subtracted 11 variables. See, 11 variables is the difference for second one. Again, 37 minus 11, the value, we are adding 26. Now see, 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. The value we are getting as 268 is the correct answer. Just find the difference between the number. Now see, if you find the difference between the number, the second difference they are getting common, guys. See, what is the common number here? Every time they are subtracting minus 11, minus 11, minus 11 and minus 11. And the final value become 268. So here the missing number is 268 is the correct answer. Nice, Nanavupendra. Go through the next one. the next question. The curved surface area of hemisphere. There is a hemisphere and they given as curved surface area. See, curved surface area or lateral surface area, both parameters are similar, guys. Curved surface area, if it is not a curve, if you have a sides, definitely we can define as lateral surface area. See, if any curved surface area or lateral surface area, we require perimeter into height. If it is any 3D object, you can remember the formula like that. See, we want the perimeter and the height. See, if it is a side, we have a perimeter. If you have a curve, definitely we require as circumference. See, remember the formula like that. See, so curved surface area means circumference into height. So, what is the circumference? 2 pi r and the height is radius. See, height is exactly equal to r. So, that's why the formula is 2 pi r square exactly equal to 308. See, 2 into 22 by 7 into r square exactly equal to 308. No, no, no. See, you just cancel here. 22 ones are 22. 22 fours are. Again, 2 ones are 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 7 are. Now see, r square is equal to 14 and definitely you can get r is equal to 7 centimeters radius. Now the radius of hemisphere is exactly equal to height of the cylinder. There is a cylinder they given. See, radius is exactly equal to height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder is exactly equal to 7. Okay. Now height and radius of the cylinder. Again, see, height and radius is just to get as a high, capital R. The ratio becomes 7 is to 3. We already know that 7 become a 7. Each unit is equal to 1 nana. So, definitely, height is equal to 7 centimeters. Radius is equal to 7 centimeters. Now, we want the total surface area. See, total surface area means lateral surface area plus area of bases. Remember the formula like this. If you want the total surface area is completely depends on the lateral surface area and the area of bases. Now, see, if we want the total surface area of the cylinder. Now, the total surface area of the cylinder means the formula is 2 pi r into r plus h. Now see, 2 into pi value 22 by 7. So we want answer in terms of pi means no need to convert it any fraction value. Here you took it as a pi here. And r value becomes 7. And 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. Nana. So 7 2s are 14 means 140. R value become 3 means the value become exactly equal to 65 is the correct answer. R value is the 60 ra. Yes, next one. So one more probability question. See, find the number of ways in which the letters in the word assurance in arranged such that both S and R together and vowels are also together. Now simple, guys. See, here the total number, how many are there in the word, how many letters? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So the total numbers are 9 letters. So out of, we have a 2S. We have a 2S. Then how many vowels are there? A vowel, U vowel, A vowel, E vowel. The total number of vowels are 4. And the total number of remaining. So how many remaining are there, guys? See, out of 9 letters, 2S and 4 vowels, we left with only 3. What is the information? We want S together. We want vowels together. Remember, guys, together is always defined as one way. Point number one. See? We can arranging these two is one way. Vowels are together is one way. Three remaining letters can occupy with three different ways. Case. So now 3 plus 1 plus 1, the total arrangement is exactly defined as 5 factorial ways. The total arrangement is 5 factorials. Here the letters are similar. So there is no inward relation. Why? Because see, these two places are S and S means there is no change in the word, guys. If it is a similar, no need to take it as a consideration. But if we have a 4 different vowels, definitely 4 different inward occupancy can change, guys. Now see, 4 vowels can be arranging in 4 factorial. The most important part, if you see the entire scenario, we have a 2 repetition of S's. And whatever the repetition of S's, that can occupy as the denominator value. See, so 4 factorial is 24, 5 factorial is 120, 2 factorial is 2 number. So it become exactly equal to 12 times. So 12, 12 is 144. So it become 144 zero. So 1440 millis. So that is a total arrangement here. No. So concept of discounts. See, what is a discount question? See, first of all, any prices increases means markup means the rising price of CP become a MP. That is a main case. Now, for this type of question, assume one value of cost price. Now, I just take it as cost to price is equal to 100 units. 100 units, I just assume as a cost price. Now, I was markup means I was rising my price. So, any rising of price from CP become a MP, that is called as a percentage of markup. Mark up, rise the price. So 40% is increases means the value become 140. What is information? Now, from out of market price of 140 rupees, now I am allowing a discount of 25%. So 25% is discount means I was selling 75% of market price. 75% means 3 by 4th of 140. 3 by 4th of 140. See, 4, 3 is a 12 guys, 4, 5 is a. So 35 threes are 105 rupees. Now, what is your observation? My purchasing price is 100. I am selling for 105. Now, how much profit I can get? If profit I can get exactly equal to 5 units. Profit exactly equal to 5 units. Just assume one value. Based on that value, we are continue our calculation. Now, you just read that. Now, they get a profit of 420. Now, see. 5 units of amount exactly equal to 420. Just leave that information. Now, find his profit. If he earn the discount of 20%, replaces by 25. For example, if the allowing discount is 20%. 20% means what is the meaning? 1 by 5th means out of 5, 1 rupee is discount. Means what is the selling price here? 4 by 5th of 150. That is market price. Now see. 5 2s are 5 8s are now see 8 4s are 32 here 3 here 4 2s are 8 112. You can see we already know that if it is 100 rupees is cost price my purchasing I was selling for 112. Now how much I get a profit? 12 units I was getting. See if 5 units is 420, 12 units is how much? Now simply 412 into 12 divisible by 5. Now we'll do one thing guys, 5 can be written as 10 by 2. See, 5 can be written as 10 by 2. 10 by 2 means take it as a numerator is 1 more 2. Now 0, 0 cancel. Now final value see, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. We want the units place is 8. We have a single option. Then you can directly choose the option belongs to the 1000 not 8 guys. See, otherwise just multiply. 42 10s are 420. 42 2s are 84. Here the value become 4. Here 0, 504. And 504 is multiple with a 2 times the value become 1000 not 8. That is the profit if they given us discount of 20% instead of 25. So yes, this is the homework for you guys. Just find the wrong term, not a missing number. Just find the wrong number for the numbers of 102, 138, 197, 292, 425 and 634. Out of all these 6 numbers, we have a one particular wrong number. You need to recognize that number and choose your option. Just go through that homework question and post your answer in the comment section. Guys, don't leave the question. So is there any doubt session? Sorry, is there any doubts guys for today's session? Procedure always constant, Upendra. Remember, if you go through the time and work concept, majorly concentrated on the efficiency. If the time is given, that is inversely proportional to of efficiency. If these two parameters are there, definitely concentrated on the total work. So total work. So comparison with the three different work means just took it as LCM, then you can get that total work. Now total work divisible by efficiency, then you can get. So based on the efficiency, based on the performance, efficiency means performance, based on the performance only they can get the amount. So amount is divided only based on the efficiency. Okay, yeah? So that's it for today's session, guys. Just go through this question and post your answer in the comment section. And please share our video to your friends. And just attend all the live session, guys. So today evening, I'm going to plan a mock test related for SBA, bank examination. And just attend the session and learn the subject. If you are good at all the concepts, then you can easily crack any government examination or IT examination, guys. Yes. Thank you, guys. See you in the evening session. Bye.